see what this thing is. I know we got. We got a, what is this? 1950 Dodge Coronet. Original
AM radio.
And we've custom built this one. Want to make sure I didn't have a glare on it. It's steel and 6-volt positive ground. It's got a brand new DVC 4x10 in it. So we got two channels right here. Stereo right out of there. Stereo LED here. Operating LED right here. Changes multiple color depending on what you're doing. HD. And you're on HD channel right now. I'll demonstrate that. Toner switch. Show you how that works. Built-in mic. Extra mic. Push button operated. USB port. This is your harness you'll be getting. This will charge your phone, your devices, play a thumb drive, which comes with it. Auxiliary in right above here. And it turned out pretty nice. It's a good, clean radio. We've got the original light in it. And a lot of people don't know how to set the presets on these. You pull the cap off and you got a screw right there. Undo the screw, find your channel, push it in, let it back out, tighten the screw, put the cap back on. This one here is a toner switch, and I'll demonstrate that, and then you have four presets on it. Toner switch is because you don't have a built-in toner here, so that we're going to actually change the volume knob into a toner, and I'll show you how that works. 6-volt positive ground, we got the original plug in, and you'll use it, the radio's grounded, wherever you bolt it up. So it's ready to go, no different. You don't have to do anything except plug it up, hook up the hot wire, and plug the antenna in. You do have a light on the back. We run a wire out for your 6-volt light to go to your dash lights. The reason why we do that, because if you turn these 6-volt radios up with that light powered by here, that light kind of wants to dance with you. We want to keep that from happening. So. Plug that up, there ain't no need of that bulb burning unless you're out at night with your dash lights on. And because it's a pain to change one of them. You gotta take this whole front of this radio off to get to that bulb. It's actually located in a little reel up here. If you won't go to AM radio, just simply turn the radio off and right back on. The light turns to red. That's 650 here and there. Off and right back on. Take it right back to FM. HD, it's going to lock right in on it. There's HD. Now you do have sub channels on your HD. And that's where this push button comes in handy. You can hide these things wherever you want to, as long as you get to it. But if you want to go to, say, channel 2, all you do is two quick pushes. 1, 2.
HD 2.
HD. 2. Back.
HD 1.
Now, anytime you don't know what channel you're on, since you got an AM radio and you're on FM, voice ID.
WMOT FM 89.5 HD 1.
We make USAA insurance from.
Presets working like it's supposed to. Now let's set up the toner. Here's how a toner switch works. Turn your volume up so you can hear the radio. Press this button in one time. You don't have to press it hard. There's a little green light going to come on. That little green light. Now this is your toner. Treble, bass. Set it where I like it. Press this button. She's going to hold the volume.
Volume hold.
Take your volume back down. And then back up, regain. This radio will also scan stations for you going down the road. You put it in scanning mode and let it scan for you. There's two ways of doing it. You can do four quick taps on the button, or take the tuning knob and turn it up twice.
Scanning for stations.
Now it's going to start scanning the stations without the needle moving. I'm going to show you how to lock on a station and actually how to even find it on the dial in case you want a preset.
Temporarily closed as our campgrounds and day use sites on national forest land statewide.
This little light pulsating over here means it's scanning. That's HD channel.
The police chief for the city of Rochester in New York State has resigned in the aftermath of the death of a black man in police.
Of the unleavened bread on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed.
We're going to let it go a couple stations.
So Jesus sent Peter and John.
There, listen online and see the schedule of this year's 28th annual Gospel Music Jubilee at King of Kings Radio.
So you like it stationary, just turn it one time.
Station hold.
She'll lock on it. As soon as she says that, it's pulsating. Start moving it, and you can find where the station is. There it is. Pull out a preset, preset. Want to identify it? One time on the button.
WFCL FM 91.1.
Or take your volume and go up. One, two, three.
WFCL FM 91.1.
That's how your voice ID, scanning and all, HD works. When the light goes solid green, it's locked on, it'll compress that sound. Not bad for a 6-volt positive. All right. We're going to do auxiliary in. You'll pull out, you get a male-to-male cord that comes with it. Just plug it in right here, and that means you can put any device on it that's got a head that puts out a signal. The MP3 players, that's what happens. This is a dropping. Too many times, that's why it looks like it does. Phone, CD changer, satellite radio, whatever you got, just plug it in, turn and bring it up, and hit play. Automatically changed over. Anytime you're on an auxiliary end device, you won't go back to radio, whatever that device is, just turn it off. You don't even have to unplug it if you don't want to. And then if you don't touch the radio in 20 seconds, it'll automatically switch back to where we had it. We're going to let it do that. But if you want to go quicker, turn it off and right back on like you're cycling from AM to FM. It remembers you were on FM. All it does is shorten that 20 seconds down.
Passes.
All right.
Driving
right
Roots,
back
of
on
course,
HD
coming
channel.
Up next week, the 16th through the
WMOT FM 89.5 HD 1.
Get together in person for passes and information about who's performing
right.
And who's doing.
That's how your auxiliary end works. Now we're going to pair a Bluetooth up.
Hey, this is Steve Pulse.
And you'll do the same thing. It'll take multiple devices. It'll always pick number one. And you bring your phone up, make sure we're on Bluetooth. Here we are. There's two ways of doing it. You can hold this push button down until she comes on and says ready to pair, or you can turn the volume up twice. Let's do it with the volume.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Showed up on her phone. All we gotta do is tap on it. She'll tell
you
when it's done.
Miss the train of-
pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Every time it goes, that light will go blue on Bluetooth. All right, we're going to do a voice command. You got a built-in mic here. You get an extra mic in case you need it a little closer to you. Plug it in where it says mic. This one will go offline. That one will come online. Now, there's two ways to do a voice command. You can hold this button down.
You can
bring your phone up, or you can turn the volume up twice just like we did pair it up. Let's do a voice command. Hold it down. Play music.
Just a sec.
Yeah, it's late in the evening. She's drinking again. I'm on it. That'll be next.
Working on that.
Yeah. Oh, you changed it up. How about that? These smartphones, they're something else, ain't they?
Sorry, I'm having trouble with the connection.
Well,
please try again in a moment.
Let's do it another way. Let's turn it back. Let's try it again. Hold it down. Play music.
I'm on it.
Let's go back.
Away from.
Stop music.
One moment.
My phone just been dropped too many times. I think it rattled her brain.
Working on that.
Yeah, I think you're drinking is what the problem is. You ain't on the job.
I'm having some trouble with the connection.
All right.
Please try again.
Let's pair it up again and let's do something here. Sometimes if you do that, go to pairing up. Let's take it offline. She'll tell you when it's offline.
Bluetooth disconnected.
Okay. Now we want to pair it up again. I'm still fine. Let's hold it down, pair it up this way. Hold it down.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Go to our settings. Show it up. Click on it.
Away from home.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Alright, let's see about the voice command. Hold it down. Play music. Alright. That's all in the phone. Mine does that every now and then. Alright, if you want to change your song, there's several ways of doing it. You can advance your music here by pressing it once. Twice to back up or repeat. Take the tuner up a notch, back. You can even do it with the push buttons. And that's how you can change your music and all. Now, incoming call. So you're getting a phone call. She'll come on and say, incoming call. You just turn this knob up once or press this button once. Answer your call and talk. When you're done, you can let the phone hang up. It'll go back doing to whatever you had it doing. You can look up restaurants, whatever you want to, here or here. Stop music. Put it in pause.
Push the gas. She didn't get it.
Now it's designed so you don't have it in your hands. That's the main thing. You can actually pull it up and hit music and go to it, lay your phone down, and play all your favorite music. HD. What we're going to do is we're going to turn it off and run a little test here. We're going to turn it back on. It'll always find. If you get in the car, turn it on and have your phone with you. She'll come on and say Bluetooth connected. That's what we're doing. That's what we're going to do. Check it out.
This is golden. In times like these.
Bluetooth connected.
There we go. Now we're going to do USB. You'll get one of these with this video on it, some music, and you take off that redneck stuff I put on there and put yours on there. But the file's already built for you. Stick it in, go straight to it. Same way, change your music here. Forward, back. Forward, back. Now that will charge your phone, your devices, so you can hide this thing. You don't have to take it out. You want to go to pause, let's go pause both ways, volume and here. Hold 1 second, put it in pause, it's going to blink a couple times, go back to radio. Same way going back to it with the push button. Back on radio, 1 second, right back to it. Now the light's changing. Or you can do the volume knob. We went up on volume for Bluetooth, let's go down. 1, 2, put it in pause, the light's going to flash a few times. Go back to radio. Down twice, go right back to it. So your toner switch, when you got it on, that little light is to remind you you got the toner switch on. Well, I've had several people call me and go, I can't get no volume. It's because the toner switch is on.
I can. Gonna fly away, by the breeze. Be on home, you and me.
I'm gonna lose my mind.
I'm gonna lose my mind.
Volume hold.
I'm gonna lose my mind. If I don't go crazy, I'm gonna lose my mind.
That's your original 1950 Dodge Coronet with a full Aurora Design conversion plus HD. Appreciate it. Excuse me.